What is up, everyone? It's Ryan, living in Cambodia, making videos so you can see what it's like to live in the kingdom of wonder, where we have beautiful bridges. Brand new bridge, Koh Norea bridge, from Diamond Island to Koh Norea. This bridge is changing Phnom Penh, and today is officially the grand opening of it. I think it's actually been open for a while, but there was a big number sign on it, and they were doing some kind of countdown, and the countdown led to today. So I was just like, I gotta get over here and check it out. I was hoping there would be some kind of, like, I don't know, ribbon ceremony maybe or something.
It is with great pride that I dedicate this new school, sports arena, or attraction.
But it doesn't matter. It's open. We're here. It looks cool. And today I'm gonna drive it. Remember I did a video in this building?
So definitely you're gonna enjoy amazing views from here.
At the time it didn't have any windows in it. Now she's all windowed up. She's looking pretty good. Pretty good. All right, let's go drive this bridge. What's this schmohawk doing? Driving in the bike lane, dummy. Windy up here. Oh God. It smells like a new bridge. It's got that new bridge smell. Check out those stayed cables. Nice stayed cables. Speed bumps are not ideal. Oh, what's this? We got a big event going on. What are you doing, Schmohawk? So this is me just driving off of Koh Norea. You can see the water here. Everything on that side is reclaimed land, I believe. Kind of a cool little bridge they put here. Highway number one is just, I don't think it's far, I think you just go follow these guys and you've hit it in 5 minutes from here, not even. So this is shaving off tons of time. I mean, obviously if I'm on the other side of the bridge and have to go all the way around, it's a lot quicker to go across the bridge. But yeah, it's connecting the city. Well, I'll let the narrator explain this.
Oh shit, is that me? Oh fuck. What's this for? Gonorrhea? Oh yeah, the bridge. Got it. With the opening of the Koh Pich Koh Norea Bridge, access to highway number one from downtown is much quicker. Google Maps says the new way, driving, not walking. We want to end here, not begin. And let's put the starting point, let's say Naga World 2. 10 minutes, 4.6 kilometers for the new way, the bridge route. What is that? You can't turn left here? You have to go right and do a U-turn. That is dumb. That's probably temporary. It's gonna be fixed. Don't worry about that. The old way was 7.7 kilometers and it would have taken you 22 minutes. That actually seems kind of generous, maybe because the traffic isn't as bad now because of the bridge. Still over twice as long, 10 minutes versus 22 minutes. Ask any of my sexual partners and they will tell you that's a big difference. What's going on here? You can't turn left here? You have to go right and do a U-turn? That's dumb.
There's highway
Highway 1 is right there. So that's the main highway, you could say, in Cambodia. It goes to the Vietnamese border. So as you can imagine, there's a lot of wheeling and dealing. Oh, I gotta get out of this dust. That's how you wreck a gimbal. As you can imagine, there's a lot of wheeling and dealing between Cambodia and
Yeah, so you can imagine there's a lot of wheeling and dealing. I don't know what this guy is trying to say. The bridge not only cuts down on transportation times, but it also eases traffic and it opens up Phnom Penh so you can live in the Koh Norea area and work downtown and not have to do the awful commute that it used to be. This bridge, this intersection, all of this area, during rush hour, it was a nightmare. I think one of the coolest things about Phnom Penh is its location, specifically that it's built at the confluence of the Tonle Sap River and the Mekong River. The Mekong is one of the world's great rivers. It's one of my favorite rivers. We've traveled up and down it. It's really cool to be living in a city built beside it. However, I do think that Phnom Penh hasn't made the best use of it. I mean, I don't know. It's hard to say, because while the main area along the river in the downtown is a nice park, it's a public space, and I don't really love the idea of companies owning land right up against the river, everyone should be able to enjoy it. That being said, I do feel the city is lacking cafes and restaurants that are on the river, places to get a meal or a coffee where you can sit back and enjoy the river. There is some of that, but I can only think of like three places. Perhaps this new Koh Norea area will be different.
Let's see what's going on down here. Not too shabby. This little boardwalk. Oh, a brown coffee's coming in here. That's a sweet spot for a coffee shop. There's not nearly enough of that in Phnom Penh. Places that are right up on the water. You can sit right in here, sip coffee and watch the river.
The bridge also opens up an opportunity for investment. Phnom Penh is growing and this area may be the next big area. Do you have the testicular fortitude to buy, I don't know, this building?
Wow, that's a pretty impressive building actually. Pretty nice spot.
There's a lot of construction going on Koh Norea, and I think there are going to be a lot of condos being built along here, so it is something to consider, I guess, if you're looking for a place to buy, maybe as an investment, or as just a cool place to live along the river.
There's a bunch of boats parked down here. Maybe they're going to start doing boat cruises from this spot. Apartment Mekong Serenity. Maybe that's a cruise ship that goes to Siem Reap. Looks like we got another crud event! Man, I've been to so many crud events. You should watch my video about the Kun Kamai fights, the crud fights. Dead end. What's this schmohawk doing?
When Cambodia's capital was moved to Phnom Penh, it seemed like the ideal place. Back then, cities were built on rivers because it allowed for quicker transportation. It's funny how all these years later, the very same river is now somewhat of a hindrance to movement in the city. But it's bridges like this one that are helping the capital spread its wings. I have no doubt that Cambodia will eventually be a megacity like Bangkok or Ho Chi Minh. I can't say that I hope that it happens, because part of the reason I love Phnom Penh is because it feels like a little big city. However, it seems inevitable, and it's pretty cool living in a city that's changing so fast. A bridge like this, in a city like this, really should be celebrated.
Ooh, Malaysia-Singapore noodle place. That sounds good. Maybe I'll get some lunch. So folks, that's it for this video. It's just a quick little video. I wanted to show you guys this new bridge. So I'll see you guys on Friday with a new video, a really awesome one. So take care, comb your hair, I'm out.